Well, I'm sad now. Apparently, it's finally an official thing. Virtual Console isn't going to come to the Nintendo Switch. And this honestly doesn't seem to have made that much of an impact on most people, which I think is a little weird. In fact, a lot of people are saying that this is a better way of doing things. And normally, I would argue about why it's a bad thing, make something about determining whether this really is a good idea, or come up with some stupid question like that, because I usually have no idea what to talk about. But for this one, I'm just gonna talk about what it is I think, because it's just too sad. Back on the Wii, or as it was known then, the Revolution, the Virtual Console started as a way to play a bunch of games on Nintendo's past systems, and it was pretty awesome. At the time, I didn't even know it was a thing, but if I did, I'm pretty sure I would have been entertained. The Virtual Console also showed up on Nintendo's following systems, the Wii U and 3DS. And because it was such a hit, it seemed like these new Virtual Consoles would be even better than the last. They would include more systems, have more of the games from those systems, and come out quicker and in a more structured way. That didn't quite happen. In fact, it seemed like Virtual Console for the Wii U was a step back from the Wii, not having as many games as quick and being more sporadic with releases. Majora's Mask is one of the best reviewed games and one of Nintendo's biggest series, and it took over 3 years to come out on the eShop. Why this was Nintendo's policy, I don't really know. Maybe the Virtual Console doesn't actually make Nintendo as much money as we think, which would be hard to imagine, seeing as it's a pretty simple transition over, and people bought games on it like crazy, but maybe for some reason it doesn't. I can't imagine why else this service would fall to the wayside like it did. It seemed like a big deal on the Wii, but on the Wii U, Nintendo really didn't seem to care at all about it. They almost acted like they didn't want to put games on it, and kind of felt like they were just obligated to do it. And based on that, and how long it had been between pieces of news on classic games on the Switch, I probably should have seen this whole thing coming. For whatever reason, the Virtual Console wasn't something Nintendo really cared too much about, and now realizing that it's not happening, I see that I should have seen it coming all along. But what really surprised me about this whole ordeal is that people who care about Nintendo games also seem to think it was the time to end the Virtual Console service. I can understand that there's probably some business or other logical reason why Nintendo would stop working on Virtual Console games for the Switch, but I can't understand why people would be happy about it. I'm not trying to turn this into an argument or anything, but I don't really understand their reasoning. One piece of it is that the Switch is doing just fine and the Wii U had it, and it still sold bad. And yeah, the Wii U did sell bad. But I don't think that anyone's arguing it hurts sales, and people bought Virtual Console games up like crazy when they could. So it isn't really like Nintendo would flop and people wouldn't love the Switch if it had Virtual Console. And another point people bring up is that the Switch Online Service Classic games will just cover that need, and because they have online support, you'll get a fresh experience. And yeah, as far as the Switch Online Service goes, that really seems like a steal. I think what they decided to do definitely justifies the price, and I have no complaints about how they're handling it. I wish it were free and like it's always been, but if it needs to be like this, this is the best way they could have done it. But those NES games aren't in any way equal to what the Virtual Console had to offer. I didn't even really get any NES games on the Virtual Console. It was the SNES and N64 and so on that I thought were the coolest games I could play. And the added online feature is really cool, but it still isn't the same. And honestly, that could actually mean the Virtual Console would have worked better, because the two systems would have been very different. One would have a smaller selection, but with online play, and one would have a large selection of the original games, and they would each use different payment methods. But simply replacing the Virtual Console with this system seems like it satisfies a completely different need. And the final reason I think is an odd justification is that not having a Virtual Console allows indie games to do better, and allows for more HD remakes to happen. And I'm all for indie games coming to the Switch, especially because it seems like AAA developers won't. Zing! But I don't see why having more games is a bad thing for players. The argument is that it gives indies more of a spotlight, and people can play them instead of old Nintendo games. But that's sort of weird. Nintendo can still do the Nindy showcases, and they can still highlight them in the eShop. They can still give as much attention and exposure to them as they are now. The Switch would be a great place for indie games either way. Heck, even the Wii U was a pretty good location for indies. The great indie scene has more to do with the lack of big third parties, which I think is why they do better on Switch than Xbox or PlayStation. And even with all the promotion and attention still given to indies, people would still rather play the old Nintendo games than they would have the freedom to choose that. Having fewer games so that people are forced to play games they don't want to play as much isn't a great reason, I don't think. And the whole thing with, if we don't have Virtual Console, we'll get more HD remakes, can just be looked at as, if it gets an HD remake, just don't release it on the Virtual Console. Plus, I don't really care about the resolution of a game anyway, so HD remakes don't really matter all that much to me, unless they fix bigger problems. But I'm also not one of those people who says a game needs to be 60 FPS. I just don't care at all. Give me a 180p 10 FPS game instead of not giving it to me at all, and I'll take it. I'm probably the minority on that, though. I don't know. I guess when you look at it from a business perspective and you're trying to get more third parties to come and focus all your effort toward other things like the Switch Online service, it might make sense that Nintendo might not think the Virtual Console is worth having. And if you think the Virtual Console wasn't a good idea to have and you're glad it's gone, that's fine, I get it too. I know I was sort of arguing against it, but that's probably just me being sad that there won't be one. I still have lots of those old games I haven't played, and I would have liked to play them while I was still able to, and it's just sad that it won't come out on the Switch and might never come out again. I think it was a great feature, and I would be super happy if it came back, and I think it's a shame that something that so many people enjoyed won't be making a return. They did leave the possibility of releasing the occasional game on it open, but I'm not keeping my hopes high for anything big. Well, what do you think about the Switch not getting Virtual Console? Just tell me or whatever, and I'll read them after I'm done pouting in a corner. Well, anyways, I'm Redkwan. Thank you all for watching, and I'll hopefully see you all later. Goodbye.